Hey there, welcome back to Clip Studio Paint Quick Tips. My name is Scott Drummond. I'm a comic artist and illustrator. Today, we're going to learn how to customize your brushes in Clip Studio Paint. But hey, this is Quick Tips. Let's not waste any more time and jump right into it. In our last episode, we learned how to create a custom brush tip in Clip Studio Paint. But that's really just the first step in making a tool truly yours. So let's grab our newly created pencil and start adjusting it. In the Tool Property menu, hit the wrench icon to open up our new pencil's settings. On the left, we can see all the categories of adjustments we can make. And on the right, we can see the adjustments we can make within those categories. The little eyeball shows whether or not the slider shows up in the Tool Property menu. So you can easily adjust these settings without opening up this menu. The sliders let you drag to a value you want, or you can click the number and type in what you want. You can also use the little carrots to make small adjustments. The little button next to that displays the brush size dynamics for that category. Here's where we really can put our stylus to work using its pen pressure and tilt capabilities, if you have a stylus that supports those features. You can see that our pen pressure has a minimum value of 0. That means when you have the lightest possible pressure, the size of the brush goes down to 0 pixels. That would be an insanely sharp pencil. So I'm going to try to make it feel a little bit more realistic by increasing that minimum value to 30%. I can also adjust the tilt of my pencil. When you put a pencil on its side, a little more lead touches the paper. I'm going to try to replicate that by checking the tilt box. I want this effect to be pretty pronounced, so I'm going to increase the maximum value to 500%. I can also adjust the curves here at the bottom of the panel to really emphasize the difference. To really get that pencil on its side feel, I'm going to jump down to the brush tip and adjust the brush density. Let's click tilt on and set the minimum value to 5 and the maximum value to 100. Then we can adjust the tilt curve to really emphasize the effect. Lastly, to give our pencil a little bit smoother feel, I'm going to go down to stroke and change the gap from 16 to something like 5. Well, maybe 2. There, that feels great. There are so many ways to customize your brushes that it would be impossible to go through them all in a couple minutes, but this is pretty much the basics. Just play around with them all and find out what everything does. All right, hopefully that was helpful. If it was, make sure to leave a like down below. And make sure to comment too to let us know what kind of brush you're gonna make. Thanks so much for watching. Now get out there and make some great comics.